Hey, what is up, guys? WeTalkUAV is back, and today we will be showing you how to make a great night photography with your drone. So stay tuned, watch it till the end in order to see the final result and see how great it is. Now let's get started with that. First of all, I want to introduce you this picture, and I want to tell you that it was taken with Phantom 4 Pro on ISO 400 and f2.8, and the shutter speed, I don't want to go so deep into the details, but anyway, the thing that I want to tell you is that ISO 400 for this picture is absolutely great and outstanding performance, because you won't be able to get this the same ISO number, keep it as low as 400 on any other kind of drone, no matter if you're using Mavic or Typhoon H or even GoPro or whatever. Only the camera with 1-inch sensor or larger can get such a low ISO in such a dark environment. So Phantom 4 is doing great here, but it doesn't matter for us, because we will be improving this picture anyway and make it even greater than it is right now. So the first thing that I would like to do with this picture is pull the highlights a little bit down, since we get some kind of overexposed areas here and over here. So I just want to pull the highlights down, not too much though. 36 point will totally satisfy me. And if you take a look at histogram, it is pretty dark, and we get a lot of data on the left, which means we have a lot of shadows, and I will be recovering those shadows in order to get more details in that dark areas. So for that purpose, I will pull this slider to the right, probably not all the way to the right, but 70 points will be enough for me. And another important thing in the landscape is the clarity, and you want to push this up a little bit, because it's different from the portrait, where you don't want it to be too harsh, because you don't want to see a lot of pimples or some tiny details on a people's face, or you just don't want to make it too harsh. But for the landscape, it's completely different, because you want every single detail to be pronounced and to be as sharp as possible, and for that purpose I'm pulling the clarity all the way up. But what about vibrance and saturation, would you ask? No, I'm not touching it right now, and make sure you watch this video till the end to understand why I'm not doing this right now. So moving on, and yeah, now every landscape, especially the night cityscape, should have two or three colors, two or three main colors that you want to work with. And in my case, it will be the blue color, like here and here, and the sky and the water and the boat over here, and the yellow color, which represents a lot of light and reflections of the light over here, these buildings and other yellow and orange stuff. So I personally think that the blue color is too blue over here, and that is why I would like to pull the saturation, choose the saturation over here, and pull it to the left, not completely to the left, even though it looks very cool, but that's not what I'm trying to do here. So I will pull it to probably 50 points, maybe even less, leave it a little bit more color, make it more natural. 40 points is alright. And for the yellow and orange parts, I want to pull them up, I want them to be more saturated, and here you go, now you see the difference, and for me it looks absolutely great. Same about luminance, I will be improving the luminance of orange and yellow colors. Yellow probably too much. Let me see. Zoom it in here. See, 100% no, it's too much, it's too overexposed. So somewhere around 40 I would say would be okay for that purpose. Alright, and let's see what we have right now. For sure it's better than before, but it's not complete and it's not finished yet. So at night, obviously, you will be getting a lot of noise because of the higher ISO. You cannot keep your ISO on 100 when shooting in night cityscape anyway, and that is why we are getting some noise in the sky, some noise in the water here, and we definitely have to get rid of it. But before that, let's sharpen our picture, because as I mentioned, you want the cityscape to be very, very sharp. So going with a sharpness to 90 points, so much better looking right now, with higher radius, more details, and basically pushing all the specs over here up. And you can see that now the sky looks so noisy, it's just a disaster. And for that reason, I need to pull the masking up so I can hide the part of the sharpening artifacts here, and with the noise reduction tool and pulling the luminance to the middle, I would say. Let's see how it looks. Okay, so much better right now. Check this out. Clean sky, maybe not very clean. I would say I would push it a few points up, like 59 is absolutely alright for me. And yeah, so that is the result that we got just in a few minutes here. Now, alright, so in terms of the sharpening and some basic improvements, we are done, and let's take a look at what we got over here. Okay, now see, the picture above looks a little bit mushy, it looks incomplete, especially on the wheel side. You can see how much better looking wheel we're getting on the picture after the post-production, after our tweaks in Lightroom. And look at this building next to it. It looks like it was taken completely with different cameras. And it's pretty much the same for all the rest of the picture. Everything after Lightroom process looks better. So, but we are not done here, so make sure you stay tuned, because we still have a few minutes to complete this picture and make it absolutely great. So now what I would like to improve is the color of this picture, because right now we're getting some basic, probably boring colors, and I want definitely change it. So let's jump into the split toning over here. And for the highlights, as I mentioned, I'm using two main colors, yellow and blue, and that is why for the highlights I will be using yellow color. I will choose it over here. Look at those changes, and this beautiful. And for the shadows, I will be using blue color, and now it looks very bad. It doesn't look natural, it looks like some of those cheap Instagram filters, and we don't want that look. So, or you want to pull the saturation over here, or just move this slider in order to get the proper look that you want. I would say I want it a little bit more on that side. Just tweak it around, find the right place. It is completely different for every picture, so you want to spend some time finding that perfect spot for that color. And I would say that one is alright for me. So moving on, and now it already looks better. But why don't we make it even better by going into the camera calibration here and tweak the shadows tint to the right towards the magenta, some kind of purple color and see the difference. Okay, I love this look. And the blue primary, I would say I move it to the left, but not too much. You have to be careful with all those settings because you don't want to overkill the photo. As I mentioned in the previous tutorial, you don't want to over Photoshop anything. So, okay, I'd say 15 points is totally okay for this picture. Cool. So we got 15 points, we got beautiful colors, we basically got everything that we want. Okay, so that is it. And let's just level the horizon because you don't want to have the skewed horizon. And the final, very final step here is to crop your picture. And I love using the rule of thirds. So the third part, one third part of a picture will be the sky, and two thirds of the picture will be the land or the water in our case. I highly recommend using this rule for your photographs as well. It's just about the composition, and it might make your photo. So I would recommend using rule of thirds for your picture as well. So here it is. Here is what we get in the very end of the Lightroom process. Now let's just try the saturation if we really want it. Now this is crazy oversaturated, but adding just a tiny bit of vibrance and saturation would help. Alright, great. So basically we are done here, and this is the final result that we're getting. And let's go again to the comparison and compare our pictures side by side. Okay, here is the result. Let's get closer and see what we have in here. Now, huge difference. Everything on the right side looks so much better. It's, I wouldn't say it was taken with the same camera at all. So, moving all the way down, look at the clarity of this building here. Look how unclear it was looking in the beginning and how much better it is now. Soft and warm colors we got here. Basically, we did a great job. And hopefully you will be able to use all the suggestions that I gave you in this tutorial for your very own night shots. So thank you very much for watching. If you have a great night shot, please show it off. Show us on our Facebook page. You have to go to the www.facebook.com/wetalkuav and make a post about your night picture. Thank you very much for watching. Like this video if you find it helpful. Please subscribe to see more videos like this. And keep calm and talk UAV. Bye.